Hi, I'm Stacy. In this video, I'm going to show you what you can achieve with the section block of Getwid. Some of you have asked us for more detailed tutorials, so this one is going to be long, but there are timestamps down below if you want to jump to a particular setting. Section is a very flexible block and it can create pretty much any layout. The section is a container where any standard or custom Gutenberg blocks can be added. I am quickly adding content to my section so that you could see what is going on with the layout when I change settings. Once you add a section, it has a box display by default, but you can make it wide width or full width in the top panel if your active theme supports these layouts. Then in the right hand panel, select how wide the content added to this section should be. The content can be boxed, full width, or custom width. The default width is inherited from your active theme, but you could set up a custom default width of the content within the section block. It can be done in the Settings tab, writing Section Content Width. By default, the section's height is calculated according to its content, but it is possible to set up any height. The units can be specified in pixels, viewport height, viewport width, and percents. For example, set it to 100 viewport height units, and the section with its content will take up the full height of the screen, whatever device you view the page from. It is also possible to reset height on tablet and mobile. This is needed when you define the height for the block as 600 pixels, for example. This may be too much if one views the page from a tablet or mobile device. Thanks to the setting, the height will be reset to the height of the content on smaller devices, making it easier to view the page. Inner block's gap is the distance between each block of content within the section. It can be small, medium, normal, large, huge, and non-gap. In the padding tab, the top, bottom, right, and left padding of the section overall can be selected. Use one of the presets or create custom paddings. They can be different on desktop, tablet, and mobile devices. The same goes for margins. The difference between padding and margin is that padding is the space between the content and the border, whereas margin is the space outside the border. We can align the content both vertically and horizontally on all device sizes. The section has 5 background types: color, gradient, image, slider, and video. Getwid will pick up the primary colors of your active theme as presets for faster editing, but you are free to select custom colors. Background gradient can be either linear or radial. For either type, 2 colors can be selected with custom location. Only the linear type of gradient has a setting for angle, because radial is a circle. In order to see image background settings, select an image. There are 4 parameters for the image here: position, attachment, repetition, and size. Position is how the image is located in relation to the container. Attachment is if it will or will not scroll with the page. Repeat is whether and how the image should be repeated. And size is how the image is sized in relation to the container. In most cases, the default settings are enough. You might want to set the attachment to fixed to make the page look more alive. To add a background slider, select all the images that you would want to slide. Click Create a new gallery and insert a gallery. Then select the animation effect for the slides. Slide or fade, animation duration, and animation speed. Animation duration is how fast the images fade or slide, and animation speed is how long each image stays on the screen. You might have noticed the video at the very top. It's a background too. For a video background, you can select any video format supported by your WordPress installation. We would advise using MP4 because this format is universal and is recognized by all browsers. So the video will play no matter what browser is used by your visitors. Currently, major browsers do not autoplay videos if they are unmuted. So if you want to autoplay the video as soon as the page loads, make sure to mute it. We can also select to repeat the video or pause it after the first play, before the video is loaded, and in case it cannot be loaded, your visitors will see the poster that you select here. We can also enable video controls and change their position. Note that these backgrounds can be combined. For example, an image and a slider with images with transparent backgrounds over it. This gives plenty of space for creating designs, but it also means that if you add an image background and then a video background, both will be loaded on the page. To make sure that you don't load unnecessary content, remove the backgrounds that are not shown to the visitor. So my background is an image and my content is text with a button. Next, we can select a foreground for each section. It can be a color, gradient, or an image. The gradient settings here are the same as in the background. Type, colors, locations, and angle. For the foreground image, we have settings for position, attachment, repetition, and size too. Whatever type of foreground you select, we can adjust its opacity and specify how it should blend with the background. There are quite a few interesting effects here. The next setting is dividers. These are the top and bottom borders of your section. And we have plenty of options for these. Each divider can have its own height and color. Dividers are displayed behind your content by default. But by enabling the setting Bring Dividers to Top, you display the dividers in front of the content. Entrance animation is how the section appears on the page. There is a list of animation effects to select from here. It is possible to select the speed of the animation and how much time in milliseconds should pass before the animation begins and the section appears. The Advanced tab has settings for a custom ID for the section if you want to link directly to this part of the page, as well as for a custom CSS class in case you want to apply more customized design. And here are our sections ready. I hope you find more interesting ways to apply the block section on your own website. Let me know what you think about this blog and leave your questions in the comments if you have any. Subscribe to our channel for more tutorials and click the bell icon to be notified every time we post new videos. Thank you for watching and have a great one.